First, we're going to write 5 to the power x plus 1 as 5 to the power x times 5. And then we'll factor out 5 to the power x. And that's going to give us 5 plus 1 here, which is 6. We can go ahead and cross-cancel the 6 and end up with 1 over 5, which is 5 to the power negative 1. So we have 5 to the power x equals 5 to the power negative 1, which implies x equals negative 1 as the only solution.